Stand by for words from the commanding officer.
Hello, CFAY. I'm Captain Dave Owen, and welcome to this month's Commander's Corner on the 16th of May, 2013. I got something not so cool to start off with here. Over the weekend, we picked up our 14th driving and alcohol-related incident. We got a DWI over the weekend. That's not good. That's 14 on the year, like I said, and we're not even halfway through the year yet. So remember, if you're going to get behind the wheel of a car, don't be having any adult beverages before you get behind there to drive. There's other ways to get around. There's base taxis. There's taxis that go off base. There's walking. There's the trains. And you can always get a designated driver, and even the clubs have programs for it. So if you're going to spend some of that hard-earned cash that we got this week from payday, please don't get behind the wheel of a car after driving. For all those who, this is PRT season. I know CFAY is doing theirs right now. They fixed the track around the field with some new pavement. That should have shaved some seconds off your time. I hope it saved some seconds off your time. Just one reminder, though. It's still one way around Berkey Field. I've noticed some cars ignoring the one way and driving the wrong way around Berkey Field. That's dangerous, especially to those who are running on the track. When you get to that stop sign past the post office, that's a left turn only. You do not go straight and you do not drive on the track. I had a car coming up behind me while I was driving on the track last week. That was not a cool thing to experience. Sorry, I didn't speak too nicely to him when I figured out he was doing it either. But still, make sure that you understand that is a one-way around Berkey Field there. You've got to turn before you get to the ball field right there at the corner. If you haven't got your whites ready, you should. We shifted to the summer uniform on the 15th of May, so we are now in the summer uniform, so you should be wearing your whites. Put the blues in the cleaners, get them all ready for next season now. It is now summer white season. On the 22nd of May, the semi-annual summer safety stand-down is going to occur. We're running that from 9 a.m. to 2 p.m. at the Fleet Theater. There also will be an environmental fair going on with that and some safety fairs, so come out and take advantage of that. That's going to be held at the Fleet Theater. On the 23rd of May, the base communications office is going to close at 10 a.m. That's because they're having a command function, but they will open back up the next day for normal business. May 25th and 26th is Customer Appreciation Weekend. The commissary is going to have a case lot sale. NEX is going to have some sales and giveaways, and MWR is going to have some events going on too. So come on out and take advantage on that on the 25th and the 26th of May. While speaking of the commissary, on the 27th, which is Memorial Day, the commissary will be on its holiday hours. So it's only going to be open from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m. So don't go rushing up to the door like at 7 p.m. to pick up that last bottle of barbecue sauce that you need or something like that. The commissary will not be open at that time. May 29th through the 30th is the annual security refresher training. There's going to be three sessions each day at the Fleet Theater. It's mandatory for CFAY personnel, tenant commands. You are welcome to come out and get your checks in the blocks for things like OPSEC and counterintelligence and cybersecurity. So come on out and take advantage of that on the 29th or 30th of May. May 29th through June 14th, our veterinary treatment facility is not going to have a veterinarian there, so you can't get any appointments to take Fluffy or whatever your pet's name is in to see the vet during that time frame. The over-the-counter stuff is still available if you need to go in and buy some sort of medications or flea and tick treatment or something of that nature. Hey, for all you that live down at Ikego, we'll be especially interested in this. On June 1st is the Zushi City Beach Fireworks. Those will be going down at 7:45 p.m. that night. That's usually a really good show. They'll be shooting off the fireworks on June 1st. And the mayor told me that Zushi Beach itself is going to have their opening on the 28th of June, if you're wondering when the official opening of Zushi Beach is. On June 13th, Troop 35 from the Boy Scouts is going to host a flag retirement ceremony. It'll be down at Cabana 1 near the seawall. So if you've got an old flag that you need to destroy properly, the Boy Scouts can help you out with that. A couple PWD projects I want to talk to you about. Over in Building C2 up in the auditorium, well, we had some termites up there and got some damage, and they're doing the repairs up there. I know a lot of commands like to use that facility for events and functions up there or some types of ceremonies. It's not going to be available again until around the end of July. 22 July is the estimated completion on that, if you're wondering, as they try to replace the damage from the termites. And you might have noticed around the base there's been a lot of work going on at the bus stops. The CBs are replacing some of the old bus stops with some new fancy ones. Four of those are already complete, and there's another 9 on the schedule. So you'll see some temporary ones up there while they're doing it. But the CBs are working on the bus stops, and they're going to be continuing to do that around the installation. I'd like to talk about some MWR events now. Yesterday I went to the grand reopening in Ikego of Club Takemaya. It looked really nice. It's real clean. They got a new menu there. I even sampled some fish tacos. So if you live in Ikego especially, the club there is now reopened. It was going through some renovations. They got some new furniture in there. They got some carpeting. Really cool stuff. Benny Decker Theater remains closed because they're doing a job on the stage there. It'll be closed through June 14th, so all the movies will be over at the Fleet Theater. Once Benny Decker is done, then the Fleet's going to have the same thing done there. So we're going to have only one theater here for the next few weeks, but we'll still make sure all the movies are shown. Summer camp registration. This week is the final week in order to go get your lottery numbers. So if you haven't done that yet, please do it if you want to get your kids signed up for anything for this summer. Let's see here, what else I got? Trippin' with the Troops comedy show is going to be coming down to Club A. That's going to be on Thursday, the 23rd of May at 2000. And they've got three comedians that are going to be there, Daniel Dugar, Tony Woods, and Mark Gilroy. I know nothing about these three, but I hear they are very, very entertaining, and we were advertising them. So come on down and check out the comedians at Club A. On the 25th of May, that's during the Memorial Day weekend, we've got a couple sporting events going on. There's an intramural basketball tournament happening, and there's also an intramural one-pitch softball tournament going on. So see, that's a good tournament for me because you pitch to your own team and you want to get lit up like a pinball machine. So it's okay if they knock the ball over the fence when I'm pitching in that tournament. All right, okay. All parents who haven't completed the mandatory school re-registration can still do so at their school's registrar's office. So if you haven't done that, please do so you can get ready for the next school year. Bikes and fire hydrants. Fire hydrants are not a place to park your bicycles. We're having a big problem with that recently. I want to put this word out. We got to keep those clear. We got to keep the fire hydrants and the fire lanes clear. We haven't been doing any confiscations of bicycles or anything, but if you park one near a fire hydrant here real soon, you may come out and it might not be there when you get out from wherever you're at. We got to keep those clear. So please do not lean your bicycles up against the fire hydrants. I know it's a convenient way to store it, but we need to keep those clear in the event that the fire department need to get to the hydrant and battle some flames. Finally, energy conservation. We're still focused heavy on that. Remember, we got that big UT bill we got to work on. We just got the numbers in from March 15th to April 15th. We just came in under our goal. We saved, remember, we're trying to save 15%. We only saved a little over 12% during that time frame. So we're right in the ballpark. We're almost there. And then, of course, I've already been receiving complaints about the ACs not being on. Just like to remind you, the policy from higher headquarters, and I'm talking all the way back in D.C., is we are not allowed to turn the ACs on until we get at least 3 consecutive days of 80 degrees and the predictions are the temperatures are rising. We haven't even come close to that yet. We haven't even gotten near it. So I wouldn't anticipate the ACs being turned on fully until sometime in June. So I'm probably not going to be able to get them on in the month of May just by the way the forecast looks. Well, I'm going to take a break now, then I'm going to be back with some really cool guests.
Sexual assault is not tolerated and can occur without regard to gender, spousal relationship, or age. If you are a victim of sexual assault or know someone who is, contact the Yokosuka Sexual Assault Hotline number to make contact with the Duty Victim Advocate at 090-8046-5783, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week.
Hello, CFAY. I'm back and I got some cool guests with us. We're going to be talking some CSI stuff. Now, that's not crime scene investigators, so I don't have Grissom and Warwick Brown and Catherine here with us today. They're representatives from the school who just went through some accreditations, and that's why they're here to talk to us today. Welcome, ladies, and nice to see you today.
Nice to see you.
Who do I have here?
Edie Duncan from Sullivans Elementary.
From the elementary school, and
Rachel Nelson from Kinnick High School.
From Kinnick, the Red Devils. Go Devils. All right. And what do you have to tell us, ladies?
Well, our schools just went through an accreditation process. We had visitors from stateside and within our DODEA structure to evaluate how our school is functioning and our staff is working and our students are learning.
Are we functioning and learning?
Yes, we are.
All right, cool. Thumbs up.
Yes, we are, definitely.
Basically, we just went through the accreditation and they came and the both schools passed. We are fully accredited, which is great news.
Yes.
We all got powerful practices as well as some recommended actions that have to be taken place within the next 2 years. They're always looking for ways to improve us. Just like an NSERV, they're always looking for ways to improve the ships.
All right. Could you share with us what some of those practices are?
Sure. For Sullivans Elementary, we received an action where we need to work on using our data for instruction and how to implement that into our everyday teaching.
Okay, cool. Anything?
And we also got the same one, using data and being able to drive our instruction using it and to also continue to revise and implement and systematically in place our CSI process as well as professional development. And we got some powerful practices, good things that we're doing, teachers working together, and our great leadership by our principal.
Okay, cool. How often do they do these accreditations?
They're every 5 years.
Okay, so we're good for the next 5 years at these two schools?
Well, we are good for the next 5 years for a visit, but we have 2 years in which to improve or show improvement in our required actions.
Okay, cool. So we're looking good for the next 24 months.
Yes, we are looking good, sir. Yeah.
All right, that's good news. Hey, so if your kid's going to graduate within the next 2 years, they're good to go. All right, cool. Is there anything else you have to share with us today?
We'd just like to thank our community and the command for their continued support, for coming out to the schools and being involved with their students. That is one way that teachers can help the families and families can help the teachers. Okay. By making sure that we build that connection and that community structure within our school.
All right, cool.
And the accreditation team really said that we have excellent students and they're so involved within our community here as well as the global community with our Japanese host nation, and they were really appreciative of how much support they have from the commands and the community as well as, you know, the fact that you met with them and were able to talk to them.
Right. Cool. Well, thank you, ladies. And
thank you.
There you go, CFAY. The schools are good to go. Okay, CFAY, I'm going to wrap this up with the trivia. From the last couple videos, the song I was looking for, which I never got an answer for, was to the TV show Cheers. I was looking for the theme song to the TV show Cheers. The game I was looking for was Rock'em Sock'em Robots. I mean, I had that when I was a kid. Most people probably don't realize that was a precursor to Transformers. The two robots in the ring represent Optimus Prime and Megatron, two of my son's favorites. He's got all those Transformers and everything. I got him a Rock'em Sock'em Robot game for Christmas last year, so it's pretty cool. He knocked my block off. All right, nobody gave me an answer to that one either. But for the sports question, I did get an answer. Roger Drake gave me the answers to what was the fastest miles. Now, nobody's done this on our track here at CFAY, I'll guarantee you that. For the men, it was Hickam L. Guerrero. Well, that's as close as I'm going to be able to pronounce that. 3 minutes, 43 seconds, and 13 one-hundredths for a mile. That's pretty quick. And from the women, it's Sevlana Master Lakova. Definitely not an American. 4 minutes, 12 seconds, and 56 one-hundredths. Those are the world records for the miles for both the men and women. I don't think we're going to see that broken on our PRTs anytime soon. But it was okay question. All right, now for a new song I'm going to put out there. Here's the lyrics. See if you can give me the title and an artist that does it. I'm proud to be on this peaceful piece of property. I'm on sacred ground, and I'm in the best of company. All right, who do you think did that song, and what's the title of it? I came up with a little military question for this one. You know, how is a military working dog's rank determined? A military working dogs, they all have a rank, but how do they determine what rank a military working dog is? And I'm going to do a sports question. I've thrown out some first pitches at the minor league games. Fortunately, they never put a speed gun on me because it probably was too slow to register. But that made me to think, what is the fastest Major League Baseball pitch ever recorded? Who threw it, and who was the unlucky batter that had to watch the thing go blazing past him? All right, what is the fastest pitch, and how fast was it, and who threw it, and who did it go by? Well, thing about baseball, well, the Yokosuka Bay Stars are in town this weekend. They're playing both Saturday and Sunday, so head on over to Palma if you want. Only 1,000 yen to get in the game. I think it's a 1,400 game on Saturday, a 1,300 game on Sunday. They're playing the Lions, so the Muffin Man won't show up in his Eagles outfit like he did in Yokohama last night. You go, season tickets to the Bay Stars, and you wear an Eagles ball cap. I'm not too sure that's very cool. But either way, he owns the records for the most dates to the Navy ball, so let's not give him a hard time. All right, now to wrap everything up there, CFAY, reminder, good shipmates don't let shipmates drink and drive. Good shipmates don't let shipmates do drugs. And good shipmates don't let shipmates, and they do not conduct sexual assault. Have a great and safe weekend.